Welcome, everyone, and thanks a lot for joining us in a discussion on Azure AD password protection. In this series of videos, we will cover details of password protection and smart lockout, the password validation algorithm, and the steps to deploy password protection on premises. My name is Akashi Kapoor, and I'm a senior PM in Microsoft's Identity Division.
Hello, everyone. My name is Rohini Goyal, and I am a PM in Microsoft Identity Division as well. Now more than ever, it's becoming increasingly important for us to secure our online accounts. We are all using several digital services, and we constantly find ourselves having to configure passwords every time we create a new account. We're falling into insecure habits by using common expressions and reusing these common passwords. Now, unfortunately, hackers are smart, and they understand these tendencies. They know that the passwords that are easy for us to remember are also easy for them to guess. Identity-related attacks are on the rise. Hackers are getting smarter and more strategic in performing attacks and compromising user accounts. If we look at the statistics, there has been a 250% increase in phishing attempts in 2018. Microsoft's Leak Credential Service has processed over 5 billion credentials in 2019 alone, of which 50 million accounts were marked as compromised. Password spray attacks are becoming increasingly prevalent. This is when a hacker chooses a set of passwords and uses them across multiple accounts. They just need one account to match one of these passwords to get access to your organization's resources. Common passwords that users configure and bad actors attack includes words such as the different seasons, months in a year, numbers themselves, or number patterns. However, when performing targeted attacks, bad actors choose words and phrases that are unique to your organization. Users in your organization will be more inclined to use passwords that include product names, location of your headquarters, and your CEO's name. And once again, bad actors are smart and know about these patterns. So we need to start preventing our users from using these easily guessable passwords.
Well said, Rohini. To add to what you said, the best way to solve this issue is to actually completely move away from passwords and go passwordless. Microsoft has been on a journey to provide a seamless, secure, and passwordless access to all your Azure AD connected apps and services. While we're in the middle of this transition to passwordless authentication, we still need a solution to help our customers protect their environments against weak passwords, both in the on-cloud and on-prem. This is where Azure AD Password Protection comes in. Azure AD Password Protection helps you eliminate easily guessable passwords and customize your lockout settings for your environment. Enabling this can dramatically lower the risk of being compromised by password spray and brute force attacks. It protects accounts in Azure AD and Windows Server Active Directory by preventing your users from using one of the million weak passwords. It checks from a constantly growing list of most commonly used passwords, plus millions of character substitution variations of those passwords. After performing extensive research and analyzing passwords that commonly appear in breaches, Microsoft has developed the Global Banned Password List, which is a list of common passwords. It is powered by Azure AD, which regularly updates based on learnings from billions of authentications and analysis of leaked credentials across the web. To help protect you against targeted attacks, you can also configure your own custom banned password list, which contains words and phrases which are unique to your organization. These two lists, combined with the banned password algorithm, are then used to generate a password validation score. Every single password change and reset in Azure as well as on-prem is assessed for password strength. And only the strong passwords that are hard to guess are then allowed. Azure AD Password Protection also provides an integrated admin experience to control checks for passwords in your organization, in Azure and on-premises. One thing I would like to emphasize here is that password protection is not a traditional password policy. It's not about min and max complexity requirements and so forth. Our research actually shows that having these password complexity requirements are causing users to opt for guessable password patterns, which we need to avoid. Instead, password protection checks for your password strength using a password validation algorithm.
In addition to leveraging the banned password lists, password protection also enables customers to set their own lockout settings. Now, account lockout is something you may have experienced with other services. We've all forgotten our passwords and tried to guess it multiple times, only to end up being locked out of our account. If a bad actor is attempting to guess your password, and assuming you have configured your custom banned password list and deployed password protection in your environment, a bad actor won't be able to guess your password. These failed authentication attempts will lock out the account. Traditional lockout systems lock out both the bad actor and the genuine user. We wanted to make a protection mechanism that prevented bad actors from getting into your account while allowing the genuine user access to their account. And this is where Smart Lockout comes into play. Smart Lockout is just that. It's smart. It differentiates login attempts coming from a bad actor versus that of the account's genuine user. The added benefit of Smart Lockout is the ability to configure your own lockout settings. The default setting, which is on for all cloud-based authentications, is 10 failed login attempts will result in a 60-second lockout period. Once the 60 seconds have passed, if the 11th login attempt is still incorrect, the 60 seconds will start over again. And over time, this behavior will cause the 60-second period to grow. Depending on your organization's policy or different compliance rules, you can configure a stricter policy by decreasing the number of attempts and increasing the lockout period. Now, just a few things to look out for. Repeating the same incorrect password will not contribute to the lockout counter. Only unique passwords will increment the counter. And additionally, Smart Lockout works with pass-through authentication. So thank you so much, Akashi, for being here with me today.
Thank you so much for having me here.
And thanks to all of you for watching the video, and we hope this was helpful for you to understand what password protection is. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to aadppfeedback@microsoft.com, and Akashi or myself will be more than happy to help. We hope to see you all again in our next videos, which will dive deeper into Azure AD password protection, banned passwords, and how to deploy it in your environment.